For you and I, the same God who promised us that He be answering us. Maybe when we pass through the warrior, the sea, or the fire, God is with us. He is the one we need to be courageous and to trust, even as we pursue His perfect will and every agenda that we set. Wherever we find ourselves, the thing we cannot stand, the thing God is pressing on our heart to pursue, the right thing, the righteousness that God wants us to seek for our family, our church, our society, and our workplace. May we be bold and courageous enough to pursue this wonderful will of God, and the hand of God will be with us. Esther's book we have begun studying and will continue next week is encouraging enough, showing us how God's people were indeed preserved from destruction, and God continued to preserve us from every destruction from the enemy. God will keep us. And it is also showing us that no matter what, it is God's sovereign will that will come to pass. And that is why we, who are in leadership position, must be conscious that God places people in positions to advance His purpose. It is a caution on all leaders to ensure that we promote the welfare of the land. God's grace, God's favor upon us is to serve His purpose. Have you been favored by God? Like Esther was favored, an orphan, a widow, a poor person, uneducated, less educated, semi-educated. Have you been favored as a prophet? Have you been received the favor and merit of God? What has God blessed and gifted you? Contacts, relationship, resources, what have you? Yeah, to use all the grace, the favor, the mercy, the provisional resources, the opportunity God has given us to serve His purpose. That is one great lesson that the book of Esther teaches us, even as we walk to fulfill the will of God in order to be fruitful. So we meet again with the good Lord, strengthen you and bless all of us. Amen.